Hey, this is Deepak here from digitaldeepak.com and welcome to another video in your Zapier Mastery course. So today we will have a look at different use cases of Zapier, and what I will do is that I will go ahead and set up Zapier for some of my own automations in my business so that you can look at it and learn how Zapier works and how you can use it for your business. So you will get plenty of new ideas how you can use it for your business. And in the previous few videos, you might have seen the introductions to Zapier. So by now, I hope you know what a webhook means, what a zap means, what is a trigger and action, and basically some general understanding of how to navigate through the Zapier interface. So what I'm going to do right now is that I'm going to connect Google Sheets and I'm going to connect my landing page. So to connect Google Sheets, what I will do is that first I will go ahead and get a new sheet on a drive, and that is the first thing that we have to do. So I will go to my Google Drive account and I'm going to create a new sheet and I'm going to call it Leads Tracker. So basically I'm going to collect the leads that I'm getting from my Unbounce landing page and I'm going to put it on a sheet. I can directly send it to ActiveCampaign as well, but I want some tracking here. So I will say Leads Tracker, and basically what I will do is that I will go ahead and add a webhook here inside Unbounce, because Unbounce does not have a direct integration with Google Sheets. So you can see that ActiveCampaign is available as a direct integration. So I can go ahead and connect ActiveCampaign directly without using Zapier, but I need Google Sheets separately. So what I will do is that I will click here on webhooks and I will click on add a new webhook. So here to capture data from the landing page, I need a new webhook. So I will go ahead and click on make a zap and click on webhooks here, and I will also name this app. I will say Unbounce landing page to Google Sheets. So it is usually a good idea to have descriptive names here so that you don't forget what the webhook is about or what the zap is about. So I will go ahead and click on save and continue here, and I will get a new webhook from Zapier here, which I can go ahead and post it on Unbounce. So I will go ahead and paste the webhook here, click on next. There is something called configure field mapping where you have to enter name, email ID and source, and I will go ahead and click on done. So the name, email ID and source has to match accordingly. That is not something to be worried about right now. So basically remember the last few digits of the webhook, so 3173. So that's what we have here, 3173. And I will click on OK, I did this. So now Zapier has to pick up a sample data so that it can map it with the sheets. And right now it is searching for sample data. So what I have to do is that I have to go ahead and enter some new data inside the landing page. So I will go to learndigitalmarketing.com landing page. And here I will just go ahead and sign up with one of my email IDs. So I will just say Deepak plus test at pixeltrack.in. And whenever you are using a Gmail ID or any email ID connected with your Google Apps account, you can use basically the plus operator and add anything beyond it. Basically, it will land in the same inbox as Deepak at pixeltrack.in, but for the place that you are signing up, it will be treated as a new email ID. So it's like you have unlimited aliases. Now I will go ahead and click on get your free lessons. And as soon as I clicked on get your free lessons, you can see that the sample data has been picked up by Zapier here. And Deepak plus test at pixeltrack.in. And these are all the data that we have captured from the landing page. So Unbounce has posted this data back to Zapier via the webhook that we just gave. And Zapier has caught that data. So now I will go ahead and click on continue and I will click on add an action step. So here we will be adding Google Sheets as the action step. So here I would want the data to come here. So email ID, name, source. So these are the three different data that I want to capture, and if I want to capture on which landing page that they are getting the, or in which landing page they are entering the information, I can also put the URL. So this way, if I am having an exit pop-up on my blog and getting the data here, then I will also be able to see on which page I am able to get the maximum amount of leads. So that is something that I will show you in the future video tutorials on how to capture which page of your blog they have come from. So for now, I think this much information is enough, and eventually I will also add revenue tracking here, and I would want to know which of these leads are purchasing the 100-day blogging course and the digital marketing mastery bundle. So I will also add 100 DBC here and DMM bundle. So this is something that I will show you in the future tutorials on how to add revenue tracking, where you can take data from your payment gateway and put it back on the sheet, not as a new row, but as an update to the same row. So that is going to be a separate tutorial. So for now, let's say email ID, name and source is all we need, and we are going to map the data from this particular sample data to the Google Sheets, so that Zapier can know how exactly to treat future data that is coming in. So now what I will do, I will go ahead and say that I need to create a new spreadsheet row, and I will click on save and continue, and I will use mail@digitaldeepak.com, which is the account I have the Google Sheets on. So here I have to select the spreadsheet leads tracker, and I have to click on sheet 1. So now I will just map where the email ID has to be entered. So here one more thing that I would like to do is add a category called lesson 1 completion. So I will explain it to you in the future lesson. So I'm also going to track whether someone has completed lesson 1 after they have opted in into my landing page. So now if I want the new header to be shown here, I just need to click on refresh fields. So obviously these are not going to be filled up by this Zap. So only the email ID, name and source is going to be filled up by this particular Zap. So now I also want to add this thing called source. So right now source is unknown because it is a hidden field inside my landing page. So if you go ahead and look at my landing page, I have added a hidden field called source, and the hidden field is very important to track different sources of data coming in. So if I go ahead and click on this, and if I go ahead and click on edit form fields, you will be able to see that there is something called source, and the default value is unknown. So right now, since we have not mentioned the source, it has come out as unknown. And what I will do is that I will go ahead and capture another sample with the source data, and I will show you how to capture the source. So I will click on get more samples. So now it is looking for more samples. So I will show you how the source works. So basically /?= source. If I'm going to send traffic to this particular landing page with /?= source, and let's say the source is Digital Deepak, and if I am mentioning the source as Digital Deepak, let's say I have linked the landing page from my blog and that is the source. If it is going to be AdWords, I can put source as AdWords. If it is going to be Facebook, I can put the source as Facebook. So here if I go ahead and enter a new data here, so I would enter deepak+test2@pixeltrack.in and click on get your free lessons. So now it is also going to collect the source from the URL parameter, and it is going to put it inside the hidden field inside the form. So now this is going to be the data that I just collected, deepak+test2@pixeltrack, and here you can see the source would have been captured here. So here you can see Deepak is the source. So if I click on continue, and if I now go to Google Sheets, create spreadsheet row, select the Google account. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the new data that we have just pulled in. So email ID is deepak+test2, name is Deepak, and source is going to be Deepak. So here you can see the source. So source is Deepak, And URL also we can add, but in this case it's just going to be the page from which we are collecting the leads. So let's say, so here it says the URL where the lead was generated exactly, so we can add the URL, and these fields I will leave empty for future Zaps. So now I will click on continue, and now I will send test to Google Sheets. So if you send test to Google Sheets, it will write the sample data that it just collected, and whenever we are getting a new lead, you can see that it is going to be written here. So even if you can transfer data from the landing page directly to your email marketing tool, I would recommend that you go ahead and capture the data in Google Sheets first, because based on this data we will be able to build dashboards, and that is something we will discuss in the Google Data Studio course on how to use this Google Sheet as the database and use the data here to go ahead and build a Google Data Studio dashboard. So for that it is very important. And so now that we have set it up, whenever a new lead is going to come in, it is going to get written on the sheet, and that's all for this Zap. So now I will select that the Zap is on, and right now we have folders, so I would just go ahead and leave it in the home folder right now. And what I will do is that I will create a new folder for every funnel. So let's say funnel free digital marketing course. So this is the funnel, and I would just go ahead and put this particular Zap inside that funnel. So let me go to home, and let me just look at where my Zap is. So all the other unnecessary Zaps I will delete. So here we have unbounced landing page to Google Sheets, and this is for that particular funnel, which is the free digital marketing course. So I will start organizing everything according to the funnels. So now I will put it inside here. So I have a bunch of Zaps here which I am yet to categorize, but we will get back to it. So I hope in this video you learned how to connect, let's say, a landing page and Google Sheets, and how to transfer data and write data to Google Sheets. So you can use this on any landing page tool. Most of the landing page tool will come with either direct integration, or they will also come with an option for at least where you can use webhooks. So right now, since I have made a few changes to this site, I will go ahead and click on republish. There is not much changes that we made. But let me go ahead and click on republish, and let me go ahead and check the URL if everything is working all right. Might as well go ahead and create another opt-in to make sure that these opt-ins are being written to Google Sheets in the real time. So let me go ahead and say www.learndigitalmarketing.com, and I would add Deepak plus test 3 at pixeltrack.in. So now if I submit the data here, it will come here in real time that you will be able to see. So I'm just clicking on get your free lessons, and you can just watch this space. You can see that in real time, Deepak plus test 3, Deepak, this time we have not put the source, it is saying unknown, and this is the URL, and this has been done. So thank you for watching this video. Go ahead and experiment with landing pages and webhooks. And if you have any doubts, go ahead and leave a comment below, and I will answer your question either in the comments, or if there are enough comments with the same question, I will go ahead and create a new video tutorial for it. Thank you, and bye bye.